这边是 Everything Rush Track， 然后是由 Rush 台湾社群所主办。那 Rush 台湾是一群喜好 Rush 的同好在台湾，然后我们每个月在台北都会有 Meetup。那大家如果对 Rush 有兴趣的话，之后可以来参加。然后如果对我们社群有兴趣的话呢，可以上网 rush.tw， 那你就可以找到我们的 Facebook 和 Telegram。 那我们演讲即将开始，掌声鼓励。你好
，everyone. Okay, that means I said it correctly. Did I say it correctly? Okay. So I'm Devanshi, and I'm from India, and I'm a software engineer at Red Hat, and I'm a Mozilla tech speaker. I contribute to Mozilla. And today I'm here for this talk called Get Started with WebAssembly and Rust. So recently I've been, I've started, learning about WASM. So WebAssembly is called WASM as well. And so I'm going to share my learnings with you today. And probably you also can get started with WASM and Rust. So today what we are going to do is, we are going to see like what is WebAssembly, why do we need it and why are we using it, why it's created, and how it works, okay, how we can use it in our projects. So what is WebAssembly? This is a very typical description or definition in the books. Like WebAssembly, it's abbreviated as WASM as well, is a binary instruction format for a stack-based virtual machine. WASM is designed as a portable target for compilation of high-level languages like C, C++, Rust, enabling deployment on the web for client and server applications. Now, did you guys understand it? Okay, so I have next slide for you guys. So basically, in very simple words, what this is, it's basically a new type of code that can be run in modern web browsers and provides new features and major gains in performance. So how many of you are JavaScript developers here? Okay, or web developers, okay. Okay, so I'll just talk about it and probably you will get it. So if on the left image you can see, so what basically WASM does is, so we have this hello.c program. Okay, and I have written some very basic addition of two numbers of a code. And then like I just need to convert this code to WASM format. And what I can do is using this M scripting, it's a SDK, it's a toolkit which actually compiles your hello.c file or code into WASM format. And this WASM format can be included in your JS files or HTML files. So think of it is like if I want to create a web application and I don't want to use probably Node.js or I don't want to use any server-side JavaScript and I just want to use Rust or probably C or C++ or Go, what I can do is I can write all the code in Go or any other language or Rust and then I can actually compile this code into WASM and this WASM file can actually be included in my web application and it can run there. So if on the right side you can see, this is a textual format. I don't know if you can see or not, in textual format there is a function written called add2. So basically that's a function which I wrote in hello.c file. So like this textual format is more for people to understand how the WASM code looks, but actually it looks like this binary format. So this binary. So let's see the next slide. Okay. So I'll explain more when we delve deep into more. So why do we need it? So what I personally see is major performance gains like speed, then portability and flexibility. I'll explain all these things in next slide. So speed. So in JavaScript, if like you are familiar with JavaScript, when JavaScript is converted to executable code, it does a lot of things. So for example, in JavaScript, if I write A plus B is equal to C, it means a lot of things. It because JavaScript is a dynamically typed language, scripting language, what it does a lot of things like parse, compile, and then optimize the code, and then you get the executable code. But with WASM, what we do is we already get the compiled code. So it does not have to, we don't have to go through all these steps of compiling a code into binary. That's why it gives you a major performance gains. So portability and flexibility, this is why I personally like WASM. So I'll give you an example, very basic example. So in Red Hat where I work, I was actually implementing a web application which is more like a dashboard. So it had a lot of statistical data, like charts and everything, like line chart and graphs. So what happened, we were using Node.js in the backend, and there was a lot of computation for all these dashboards. So when I came to know about WASM, I got to know that, okay, what I can do is, I can actually write all this computation wherever I need to do all this heavy computation for the charts and algorithms, and you know, probably 3D images or 3D shapes, geometrical shapes, I can actually use WASM there. I can actually use, probably I can write that code in Rust instead of writing it in Node.js or JavaScript. So that's why, you know, I started using WASM. So for example, when you write a source code, it needs to be compiled into different, according to different environments. Like for Mac, there is a different thing. For Windows, there is a different way of implementing a C code or Rust code. And then in Linux, there is a different way. And in Mac, again, like you have different processors as well, in Linux as well, and Windows. So what we are doing is, and we can write all these, so we don't have to write different programs to, you know, support each of these environments. We can write just one, program, compile it to WASM, and you know, and it can run into browser. So these are the scenarios where WASM can be really efficient, like video games where you have a lot of, you know, heavy compilation. So for example, like you need to do this video editing, and video editing softwares, and you have to do 3D rendering, like 3D shapes, geometrical shapes, as I said. Then in music production is also used, and artificial intelligence where you have to run like a lot of algorithms. So all these are the scenario, like real life scenarios where you can use WASM. And there are a lot of, for demo purposes, there are a lot of games which are made in WASM for you to see and to compare the, you know, time. Yeah. So how it works? As I said, if you see on the left, compiling source code for different processor architecture. So for example, if you have one source code, you have to write it or compile it for different architectures. But in WebAssembly, there is a intermediary compiler target. I mentioned. WASM, I compile my source code into WASM, and this WASM, so basically WASM is binary code, so it will work on any machine or any processor. And also you can see if you can see on the left, there is like C, C++ or Rust code, and I just compile it to WASM, and I can actually include this WASM file into my JS, JavaScript code, and this JavaScript can run on my browser. So how are we able to do that? So what happened? So if you know, when initially JavaScript was created, it was more for, you know, beautifying the HTML pages or your websites. So, but then like when people started using JavaScript a lot, they added a browser VM inside the browser. And that's how, like, if you use AngularJS or React, so that's how, like, they can compile all these code. So that's how, like, they added this browser VM. Now what they have for WASM, what they have done is, they have exposed this browser VM outside. So now you can run all the, like, any code if you want, like Rust or any high-level languages code into this browser VM. So it's available for you know, for running this these kind of code. So what I'm going to do is I'll give you a demo. So like I'll do respect the timeline as well. What I'm going to do is, instead of directly giving you a demo, I'll first show you the screenshots of the demo I already created. So how can we use WASM with Rust? So we'll write a program, we'll compile it to WASM, then we'll include it in our code, and then we'll run it in our browser. So basic Rust program running in the browser. So these are the tools which I have used. So Cargo, are you familiar with Rust? How many of you are familiar with Rust? Okay, if you're not, then you should know these terms. So Cargo is basically a package manager for Rust, like npm is for JavaScript. Then WASM pack is another tool which basically compiles our Rust code into WASM and produce packaging for npm. So for example, if I want to create a code, like Rust code, I can create actually a npm package with this WASM pack. Then WASM bindgen. It basically provides a bridge between the types of JavaScript and Rust. So my JavaScript code can talk to the Rust code, basically the WASM code, and my Rust code can actually talk to the JavaScript code. So if you can see on the screen, I just initiated a new library called cargo new-lib, hello WASM. And when I did that, it created one file, toml file, and one directory, src. So cargo.toml basically is what package.json is to Node. So it has all the dependencies and dev dependencies inside that. And src is another directory. Sorry, you cannot see the whole screen. Okay, so I'll just go ahead. So what src has? SRC has the lib.rs file by default. So lib.rs file is basically the Rust file, and it has like default code. So this cargo.toml looks like this. So it has like basic package information, the name of the package, version, authors, description, and then libraries and the dependencies. So in the dependencies, I have mentioned that I want to use WASM bindgen 0.2 version. Then in lib.rs, so this is the file, and this is the code I have written. So what this code does is, if you can see on the top, it says extern create WASM bindgen. So they basically crates are packages, libraries in Rust. So what I'm telling this program to do is, I'm saying I want to use the package, the library WASM bindgen, and use the prelude.star module of WASM bindgen library. And then in the next section, you can see I've written like hash, and inside the brackets, there is this WASM underscore bindgen. So basically what it does, it's called an attribute in Rust. So whatever I write after this hash in square brackets wasm bind gen is, it's basically saying that it modifies the next statement. And it says, in this case, this statement is saying that Rust, so we are basically telling Rust that we want to call some externally defined function. So this function is called alert, and we want Rust to know that we want this function. This is externally defined function. And then in the next block, if you see, I'm again using this attribute, and after this attribute, I've defined a function called greet. And inside the greet function, I'm accepting a parameter called name, which is a string. And inside that, I'm again calling this alert function and saying hello, and whatever the string is, and welcome to COSCUP 2019 Taiwan. Now, what I want to do is, I want to compile this lib.rs file code into my WASM code. So to do that, I will just run this this command called WASM pack, and say WASM pack build --, scope Devanshi Pandey. So what basically this does is, it builds the WASM, it compiles this code to WASM, and it also, if you can skip this --, scope and Devanshi Pandey part, I've given it for my NPM package, you can skip it totally, but I'm going to create a NPM package, that's why I've given that. So it does a lot of, you know, compiling, and at the end, it creates, if you can see on the last line, it says, hello WASM package is ready to publish at ./package/pkg. Now, if I want to see the content of hello WASM folder, you can see I have pkg, cargo.toml, src and target. And inside the pkg, I have all these files created. Hello WASM, I can actually show you one by one, yeah. So inside the pkg file, pkg directory, I have this file called hello WASM bg WASM, which basically is a binary format. So that's why you can't see anything here. This is the file which we will need in our JavaScript code. And this is the JS version of this WASM file. And this, if you're using TypeScript, so this is the type definitions for the TypeScript. Now I want to publish my package into npm. So for that, I will run the command inside the pkg folder, that npm publish --, access public. And doing that, it created a, if you can see this, it created a npm package for me, library for, under my username, called hello WASM with this version. Now, I created another folder which is called Rust WASM www. So basically, this folder has, now compiled my Rust into WASM, right? Now I want to use this into my web application. So I will create my web application now. So inside that, I've created this package.json where I will add all the dependencies. And if you can see this, this is the dependency, this is the package I just published into npm. And I'm just, if you are familiar with Webpack, this is the server config for Webpack. And I'm actually, this is very basic configuration which you do. So index.html file. So in index.html, if you can see, I have written very basic HTML. And I have actually used Google Translate to translate my text in Chinese. It might be wrong, it might not be correct. And after that, if you can see this line called script src is equal to --index.js. So this is the JS file which I will create again. And this is, I've included it in index.html. So in index.js, if you can see, I'm importing the node module and I'm importing the npm package which I just created, and I'm importing this hello_wasm.js file. So this basically has all the WASM related code. And I am, if you see this, js.greet, and I'm passing this string called fellow open source warriors. So basically this is the string which greet function will use. Now, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to npm install all the dependencies which I defined in package.json. And after that, I will get all the packages, especially the package I created. And I will say npm run serve. So when I say npm run serve, the project is running at this address. And let's go. So now if you see, this is basically my HTML code which I wrote an index.html file. And after that, this is the alert box. So I passed fellow open source warriors text string to the Rust code, which you remember, if you remember. And I wrote welcome to COSCUP Taiwan. If you remember this file, in the start I showed this file. So basically in the greet function is accepting that string, and inside the greet function, it's calling the JavaScript alert method. So basically this is how your JavaScript code can talk to Rust code, and Rust code can talk to JavaScript code. So these are some of the Rust and WASM resources if you want to go through them. So you can take the link. So Rust and WASM book, this is really good book, and it has all the detailed detailed information of all the tutorials. And you can actually look at this book and actually create your own tutorial as well. And image, I follow this blog, and the images which I have taken are from this blog. And if you want to just write a Rust code and just compile it to WASM, you can actually go to this and you can compile all your, you can get all the details, all the documentation for doing that. And these are actually very good resources. And if you also want to know more about WASM and want a high level overview, just watch this introduction to, this is Lynn Clark. She's a developer advocate at Mozilla. So she has this talk at JSConf, I guess. And you can watch this video and you can get a lot of details about WASM. So if you have any questions, please let me know.
So what's the performance implications of WASM interacting with native JavaScript?
So it depends. So if I have to give you an example of games. So if you remember, if you know about Unity, it takes a lot of time, right, to load. But with WASM, I've read this article where you can actually load your games in 3 to 4 seconds as well. So I don't have a description of exact comparison between both of them, but yeah, it's very much faster, yes. Yes, so for example, if you're writing code in Rust, so whatever Rust can do is actually, you can do all those things. Multi-threading, it's supported. And currently, WebAssembly is still in very early ages. They are releasing more modules day by day. But all the basic features of a particular language, you can actually use them. And a lot of people have started using it games a lot. Yeah. Yeah, and if you go on Google and if you search about examples of WASM, you will find a lot of very short games. Any other questions? So if you think there is a language issue, so if you think like you could not understand something, you can, I'm here for today and tomorrow as well. So you can actually contact me on Twitter, or this is my GitHub repo. So you can actually tell me, you can talk to me and you can directly come to me and ask me questions about WASM and Rust. Thank you. So you can actually go to that link and see the comparison of response times for both.